So today I've come back to my old primary school, Braidbar Primary in the south side of Glasgow, because today is actually quite a special day for the primary six class that I'm standing in right now. They're getting a delivery of fish eggs, which are going to live in the hatchery just behind me.
My name is Gemma Jennings and I'm the Community Engagement Officer for the Clyde River Foundation. The Clyde River Foundation is a charity consisting of five biologists that work to research the ecology of the River Clyde, and we do a great deal of outdoor education in schools. And what's brought me here today is Clyde in the Classroom.
Okay, so today is the day that we've all been waiting for. I have a very special delivery for you. Would you like to guess what it is? It's the fish.
We're 15 years into it now, and every year schools throughout the catchment are responsible for looking after a hatchery in school with about 200 brown trout eggs, which they're responsible for about 6 or 7 weeks. They look at the life cycle of the trout, they care for them every day, and then at the end we walk down to their local burn and they set them free. So what we have a mix of alvins and eggs. Okay, the alvins have hatched out this morning.
They're all up inside the eggs.
Yeah, they're curled right
look
up.
Look at that one.
Oh, there's a white egg. There's a few white eggs.
Now these ones are eggshells, okay?
Oh. It was fantastic. The reaction was predictable in some senses, but it's just really lovely because they've worked hard. And they've been able to use so many different skills across the curriculum, and to now be able to put that into more practice just makes the project, it just makes it more understandable as to why we do it.
And see how big the yolk sac is compared to the fish?
Very small and orange. I wasn't expecting them to be quite so orange, like a bit less, like a bit more peach.
I was quite surprised that some of them were already hatching.
I thought it was like really exciting. I thought they would be and bigger, but they're actually quite small, and I'm really happy that some of them have already hatched and we got two-headed one.
They have the hatchery in school for about 6 weeks, and the children themselves are responsible for the care of the trout.
We've been learning by checking the hatchery every day by the temperature, and we've been learning about the life cycle. We know what to do when the hatchery gets a bit too hot, or if it's a bit too cold, to try and get it into the perfect zone.
You don't get brown trout eggs in your class every day. It's just like a good experience to have.
I think in the Clyde in particular, the Clyde is often overlooked. People don't actually realise a lot of the time that fish do live there.
It's quite a long project though. You do this over a series of months. It's all about the education for the children, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So it's not so much about filling the river full of fish. It's about getting the children to have an insight into something that's really quite unique, and just getting them enthusiastic about science and getting them kind of interested in the environment where they live.
It's called Golden Rules, G-O-L-D-E-N-R-U-L-E-S. 75 degrees, no go higher, please. Chlorine-free water, not from the tap. Chlorine-free water, they'll like that.